Hey everyone, hope all is good at your side. I would be speaking today about one of the most effective methods of learning and teaching, case studies. Case studies can be used in education as a teaching tool. Many students learn better using real life examples, and case studies can be an effective way to learn in the classroom. Case studies have a history of being used in business schools, law schools, medical schools, and other master programs as well. These cases can come in different forms, with some being the basic what would you do type questions and some being very detailed and requiring data analysis. Assignments and homework for these type of studies usually require students to answer open-ended questions about a possible solution to a problem. Usually, these projects are taken up by a group of students, as group learning is often much more effective. The case study method of teaching used in management education is quite different from most of the methods of teaching used at the school and undergraduate course levels. Unlike traditional lecture-based teaching, where student participation in the classroom is minimal, the case study method is an active learning method. It requires participation and involvement from the student in the classroom. For students who have been exposed only to the traditional teaching methods, this calls for a major change in their approach to learning. So, what are case studies now? A case is basically a story. A case recounts events or problems in a way that students can learn from their complexities and ambiguities. The students can learn from the original participants in the case, whether it is a business person, doctors, or other professionals. The students are able to take over a case and dissect key information in order to find solutions to the problems. This allows students to be able to 1. Determine pertinent information, 2. Identify the problem and its parameters, 3. Identify possible solutions, 4. Form strategies and ideas for action, and 5. Make decisions to fix the problems. In learning with case studies, the student must deal with the situation described in the case, in the role of a manager or decision maker who is facing the situation currently. An important point to be emphasized here is that a case is not a problem. A problem usually has a unique, correct solution. On the other hand, a decision maker faced with the situation described in a case can choose between several alternative courses of action, and each of these alternatives may plausibly be supported by a logical argument. To put it simply, there is no unique, correct answer in the case study method. It allows you to go ahead and think hard. So, what case studies are not? Case studies are not press releases. Although case studies can be used to accompany new product launches, they are not merely vehicles to talk about new products. Case studies aren't advertisements. They can be used to advertise new products or features, but it's not about you. A good case study is about a customer's journey, not your company's journey. Let's also have a quick look at the various types of case studies now. Under the more generalized category of case study, there are several subdivisions that also exist, each which is custom selected for use depending upon the goal or the objectives of the investigator. These types of case study include the following. Illustrative case studies. These are primarily descriptive case studies. They typically utilize one or two instances of an event to show what a situation is like. Illustrative case studies serve primarily to make the unfamiliar familiar and to give readers a common language about the topic in question or discussion. Exploratory case studies, these are also called as pilot case studies. These are condensed case studies performed before implementing a large-scale investigation. Their basic function is to help identify questions and select types of measurement prior to the main investigation. The primary pitfall or drawback of this type of case study is that the initial findings may seem convincing enough to be released prematurely as conclusions. We have to be aware of pilot case studies. Cumulative case studies. These serve to aggregate information from several sites collected at different times. The idea behind these studies is the collection of past studies will allow for greater generalization without additional cost or time being expended on new, possibly repetitive studies as well. Critical instance case studies. These examine one or more sites or either the purpose of examining a situation of unique interest with little to no interest in generalizability, or to call into question or challenge a highly generalized or a universal assertion. This method is useful for answering cause and effect questions. Let's have a quick look at the advantages and disadvantages of the case study method. Case studies, as we discussed earlier, are used as a tool to facilitate learning on part of the participants by the trainer. In this situation, it could be a teacher and her students or his students. Case studies portray real-life situations involving decision-making by participants on either a set of questions or through an open-ended discussion in the classroom. Usually, case studies are presented in a session by dividing the participants into groups. This enables the participants to have a thorough analysis and understanding of the case. Let's have a look at a few of the advantages of case studies. The most important advantage of using a case study is that it simplifies complex concepts. Case studies also expose the participants to real-life situations which otherwise would be difficult, especially as a student, to get an insight into what exactly is happening in a management function or in a management role. It truly helps in adding value to the participants through discussion on concrete subjects as well. It improves analytical thinking, communication, developing tolerance for different views on the same subject, the ability to defend one's own point of view with logic, and also enhances teamwork of the participants, making them efficient over time. The many solutions which come out of the case act as ready reference when participants face similar problems at the workplace for students in the future when they are ready to get into the industry at managerial positions as well. Let's also have a quick look at some of the disadvantages. Firstly, it might be difficult to find an appropriate case study to suit all subjects. Case studies contain the study of observations and perception of one person. There are chances that that person presenting the case may completely present it in one manner, missing other important aspects completely. Managing time is a criterion in a training program. Case studies generally consume more time when compared to other instruments. For shorter duration programs, case studies may not be the best medium available. Since there is no one right answer, the problem arises in validation of the solution because there are more than one way to look at things. It is best suited to advanced training programs when compared to basic level training programs, and a certain level of maturity of participants is required as they have to participate in the case discussion. But having said that, I would also like to add here that the advantages far outweigh the disadvantages, as the case study approach provides for experiential learning and is a great tool in stimulating learning in training programs.